Hey, what's going on, guys? Today we're gonna talk about the 5 common gimbal mistakes you could be making. Some are for beginners, but definitely one of them I'll be making it. So yeah, let's go. Mistake number 1, not doing the gimbal walk. What's a gimbal walk? Yeah, he would have been like the perfect gimbal operator, but the concept here is that you have to help the gimbal be more stable than letting the gimbal help you. Now imagine walking with a spoon in your mouth with the egg on top, and the goal was to not drop the egg by running or walking. Yeah, that's the kind of walk you want to do. And to do that, you cannot walk like you're actually marching. You have to let your heel touch the ground very softly and roll off your feet to your toe. And that's the gimbal walk. And it really helps when you have shoes like this. Check this out, guys. I call this the gimbal shoes. The special thing about this is that the heel has a very curved end. And the worst kind of shoes you could wear is like a dress shoes with a really, really hard angle heel, and that's gonna hit the ground and it's gonna jerk that up and down movements. Ideally, you wanna wear a tennis shoe that has a very curvy heel. That way, when you land on your heel, it rolls off your heel to your toe without giving you that initial shock when you land on your feet. Now, you don't have to have this type of shoe, but try walking with the spoon and the egg in your mouth and slightly lower your body and walk smoothly and do the gimbal walk. You get some smooth footage every single time. Mistake number 2, turning on that gimbal without the actual camera on. Now, I do this sometimes, if I have a shoot next day, I wanna just quickly check to see if the gimbal has any juice. So if you turn on the gimbal with without the actual camera being there, it could. Oh, just kidding, it doesn't explode. This is what actually happens. It just turns on and vibrates. Seems harmless, right? Yeah, that's not good for your gimbal. Now, I always had a hunch it was actually bad for the gimbal, but Ziyun did confirm it. So it puts a lot of stress on the motor and the controller since the camera is not there, it's like looking for it. So if you want to make sure your gimbal lasts a long time, do not turn on that gimbal without the actual camera. Mistake number 3, not properly balanced gimbal. Do you think this gimbal is balanced properly? Looks of it, but when I do this, wow, yeah, it keeps coming back to the middle. That is actually not properly balanced. So to a glide cam user, that could look like a properly balanced gimbal, because on a glide cam, when you drop the camera, it does return to the center just like that. However, on an electronic gimbal, it should not act like this. Let me try to balance this really well and show you. So right now the tilt axis is definitely off. So if this happens, you want to raise the camera up a little bit and keep raising it up until it does this. So when I tilt the camera down or up, it actually should stay there where you put it last. So that is a properly balanced gimbal, because now the motor doesn't have to work as hard to get to that position. And this concept basically applies to the roll axis and pan axis, that when you put it into that position just like this. So right now, I'm gonna test the pan axis. You see how it's staying there? And same thing with the roll axis. If I tilt it, it should remain there without too much effort. Mistake number 4, you're operating the gimbal way too far from your body. Let me show you. If you remember physics, you guys pay attention in physics class? I definitely didn't. So, let me turn on this gimbal. So it's all about the fulcrum point. Fulcrum point basically is like a seesaw, right? So if there's a weight furthest away from the fulcrum point, it creates a lot more force than if it was actually closer to the fulcrum point. So if my elbow or my shoulder is a fulcrum point, and if I have my gimbal way out there, any down force will actually create a lot more force than if I were to have the gimbal closer to my body. So ideally, you want to have your elbow as a fulcrum point rather than your shoulder if you reach out really far. Right now, this is a Crane M2 with the light RX100 setup. It's super light. It doesn't create a lot of force up and down for me to not control it easily. But if your camera was a lot bigger and you have a lot bigger gimbal, this is especially important. So you want to have the gimbal closer to your body without actually touching your body. And that way you have full control over it and get that smooth shot without actually your arm falling off because you're so tired holding the gimbal. While I have this, mistake number 5, holding the gimbal 90 degrees exactly. Gimbals usually create the up and down jerk movement because you're bouncing with the gimbal. To avoid that, you want to actually tilt the gimbal 15 to 20 degrees so that tilt axis actually can handle that up and down movement. You see, if you have the gimbal 90 degrees, there's no motor that can compensate for up and down movement, whereas if you tilt it 15 degrees to 20 degrees, this tilt motor can actually compensate for that up and down movement. So those are the common 5 gimbal mistakes I often see. Hopefully this video does help somebody smooth out their gimbal footage. I'll try to make a detailed video about how to balance your gimbal properly, but if you have any questions about gimbals or what you're struggling with, let me know in the comments below and I'll try to help. All right, guys, that's it for me today. Until next time, make it a good one. Later.